Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel, episode 1520, Separate Dates from Text. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. This is a follow-up of episode 1518. Put that episode out where I said, hey, you know, we don't want to store the text and dates in the same cell. I wanted to use the custom number format, to actually store the date there, but put the words in. And someone said, well, hey, that's great if you were starting from scratch, but I'm getting the worksheet like this. It already has the text and the dates embedded. How can I break that out? Well, okay, so there's two ways to do this. It's kind of like a dueling Excel podcast here. The one way is first to use some text functions to separate out that date. So here we can say, we can just count that there are 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 characters before the date, and it looks like it's pretty consistent. So we can say equal mid of this cell, comma 10, comma. The most it could be is 10 characters. That's if there were two digits for the month and year. So I'll ask for 10 characters, which is going to get me a text representation of the date. And then if I ask for the date value of that thing that looks like a date, but it's text, I will get the correct answer in the wrong format. Control 1 and choose a date format. Click OK. All right, so that will actually convert those text and dates to regular old dates. Of course, now you want to select all of those, and we'll do Control C and Home, paste values to convert them to regular dates. And so now that's one method to go. Although a much faster way to go, provided there's nothing else in this column, which in this case there isn't, we can use the data text to columns. See how I was going to do Alt D E. Data text to columns. Say that it's fixed width. We don't give it a lot of sample here, so they're going to put too many in. I'm double clicking those lines to get rid of them and putting a line right there. All right, so now we have field 1, which is the text, field 2, which is the date. Field 1, I'm going to say do not import. Field 2, I'm going to import as a date, in this case month, day, year. And we can just click finish. And now our text is gone and our dates, true dates, remain. Okay, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.